you seen an animation or played a game where it looked like the sprites were affected by gravity? Perhaps they fell to the bottom of the stage in a realistic way, slowly gaining speed as they fell. Perhaps they bounced and those bounces got smaller and smaller over time. Have you wanted to create gravity in one of your projects? Let's explore how you can. Sir Isaac Newton is said to have discovered universal gravitation by observing the fall of an apple. So for fun, I've created a project with an apple sprite that I want to fall from a tree. To begin creating gravity, I'm going to set up a variable that will hold the velocity of my apple. Velocity is the speed of something in a given direction. Since the apple will be falling from the top of the stage to the bottom of the stage along the y-axis, I'm going to call my variable y-velocity. I'm going to write a script that says when the green flag is clicked, the apple should start at the top of the stage. Go to, say, 140 on the y-axis. Then I want the program to forever change the y position by the y velocity. And since my object is starting from a place of rest, I want to set my y velocity to start at 0 each time the program is run. Why isn't anything happening? Do you have a guess? Let's look at the stage monitor for my y velocity variable as I run the program. Notice that the y velocity remains at 0. That is because I haven't told the program to increase the velocity over time. I want to increase the velocity, which will in turn increase the distance the apple travels down the y-axis. I'm going to add a change y velocity by negative 1 block before my forever loop and run this code again. The apple is falling now, excellent, but it still doesn't look like realistic gravity. Why? If you observe the y velocity stage monitor, you can see that it remains now at negative 1. What happens if I put the change y velocity by negative 1 block inside my forever loop? In this program, I have two apples. The red apple has the change y velocity by negative 1 block before, outside the forever loop. And the green apple has the change y velocity by negative 1 block inside the forever loop. Look at the stage monitors showing the velocity and y position of each apple. Can you see the difference that the placement of that block makes as I run the program? I've added a small weight as well to slow down the action, so it's easier to see the values in the stage monitors change. With the velocity change inside the loop, the velocity number gets bigger and bigger over time, which means the green apple changes y positions by greater and greater amounts over time. This is acceleration, an increase in the rate or speed of something. The effect is that the green apple gains speed, falls by greater and greater distances as it's falling, giving a sense of gravity. There is one issue, however. My apple keeps falling until it hits the bottom of the stage. Perhaps that's not what I want. Perhaps I want it to appear to hit the ground and stop falling before it reaches the bottom of the stage. How can I code that? I'm going to grab a conditional if-then statement block under the control category. There are a number of options I can use as my condition. For instance, I could say if the y position is less than, say, negative 106, then this script should stop. Or maybe my ground is a different color than the other items on the stage. I could use touching color as my condition. Or maybe I want to create a separate sprite to represent the ground. For this example, I'll use if touching the sprite ground, then. And in place of stopping the script, I'm instead going to use the set y velocity to 0 block. One advantage of using the set y velocity variable block here is that I can use some math to make the apple bounce off the ground when it hits, rather than have it come to an abrupt stop. In nature, an object loses energy as it is bouncing, so over time the bounces get smaller and smaller until the object stops bouncing. We can scale down the velocity slowly to replicate that. Instead of setting my y velocity to 0, I can set it to y velocity times negative 1. Or maybe I'll try a decimal, like negative 0.9. Try experimenting with different values and expressions to see the results. And now that you have experimented with y velocity, you could try playing with x velocity, like a ball being thrown, or x position, like a ball bouncing and moving forward. Say I have a ball and I want it to bounce and spin and move forward. What blocks might I try? Perhaps a turn and change x by block. How could you use gravity in a game? Perhaps you've seen a game like Flappy Bird, where the sprite is constantly falling, but you can slightly reverse the velocity for a moment by hitting a keyboard key in order to avoid obstacles and the ground. To try this, I can add a script, like when the space key is pressed, change the variable y velocity by 10. Test this out and observe how the y velocity, and thus the y position, changes when you hit the keyboard key. For a moment, the velocity is smaller, and perhaps positive if you hit the key enough times, rather than negative, so the object changes position by a smaller amount, or even a positive amount, momentarily reversing the gravity effect until the script in the forever loop takes over again. How will you use gravity in a game or animation?